understand how to measure diameter of a small spherical body and internal diameter of any given cylinder or beaker, and hence depth also to find out the final volume of a given beaker using vernier calipers. Okay, so this I will show you the device what I am talking about. This apparatus is called vernier calipers, and today we are going to use this vernier calipers to find out. See, this is a small spherical body. We are going to find out diameter of this small spherical body, as well as we can use this vernier calipers to find out diameter, internal diameter of this given beaker, as well as depth of the given beaker. And hence, by using this formula pi r square h, we can find out volume of the beaker. So these all can be various objective of vernier calipers. We can find out many things up to the precision value of 2 decimal points. Means that any reading what we will measure using vernier calipers can be measured up to 2 decimal points. Okay, so we'll understand this apparatus first of all in detail. See, this is vernier calipers in my hand. These two are called its jaws. What do we call it? Jaw. Whatever is the objective, we always hold the objective in between these two jaws. Look at this. This is the paw. We have to find out diameter of this. So we are supposed to hold this in between these two jaws. Okay. Once we have hold it, now we will have to find out the diameter. We will be using these two scales. Now look at these two scales very carefully. Vernier calipers is made up with two scale. This central scale is called main scale, and this scale is similar to your compass scale what you use regularly. And this additional, you can see one small additional scale. This scale is named as vernier scale, and this scale helps you to find out reading up to the second decimal point. Okay, now you all have seen this vernier scale carefully. How this vernier scale is designed? So 9 divisions of the main scale is divided into 10 divisions of the vernier scale to make this efficient device to measure the second decimal point of any measurement. Okay, so now the least count, we'll understand what is called least count. The least count is the smallest value what you can measure from any device, that is defined as least count, or also named as vernier constant. We can measure it by taking ratio of smallest division on the main scale divided by total number of division on the vernier scale. As I told you that the main scale is nothing else but it is the same what we use in our compass. So we all know what is the smallest value we can measure from our compass scale, that is 1 millimeter, or in terms of centimeter it is 0.1 centimeter. And as I have shown you that the vernier scale has total number of division 10, and that's why the least count would be 1 centimeter divided by 10, that is 0.01 centimeter. Fine. So now I'll show you how to take reading from the vernier caliper. So the way I had shown you, you are supposed to put an object in this device, and then you will have to take reading of the main scale and vernier scale. I have drawn one sample reading over here for you to get it easily, to get understand this in an easy way. Let's say that you have put some object over here, and then this is your zero of the vernier scale, and your main scale has reading like a simple scale. So suppose your zero of the vernier scale is just past this reading 3.1. What will we read this first reading? This is 3.1, 3.2, 3.3. Likewise, because the zero of the vernier scale is just past 3.1. So what will be main scale reading? Over here you see the main scale reading will be 3.1. This is the observation table. In this observation table we are noting down, because we are having two scales, so we are noting down reading of main scale. And then vernier scale reading comprises with the two part. one is number of vernier division, and then multiply it with the least count will give the total reading of the vernier scale. And when we add both the reading, main scale reading and vernier scale reading, we get the total reading whatever we are finding out. So as I told you, the main scale reading is the zero of the vernier scale has reached or has crossed whatever reading of the main scale is tabulated under main scale reading. So I have shown you 0 has crossed 3.1, so main scale reading is 3.1. To find out vernier scale reading, we have to see the number of division on the vernier scale. As I said, there are total 10 number of divisions, and out of 10 division, any one division, when you will see it by using reading glass, you will find that any one division will be exactly coinciding with the some division of the main scale. Now you start checking first number of division, it is not matching with any of the division on the main scale. Similarly 2, 3, 4, 5, but you see 6, isn't it? 6th number of division is exactly coinciding with the main scale division, and hence your reading for the vernier scale would be 6. That is the number of division without any unit, 6. When you multiply this number of division with the least count, which is 0.01 centimeter as we have already calculated, then you get the total reading of the vernier scale as 0.06 centimeter. When you add both of them, you get the total reading 3.16 centimeter. Everywhere the unit is mentioned on top of the column, and that's why we are not writing unit over here, because it is already been mentioned on the on that column. So this is how you can find out diameter of the spherical body. As I told you, you can use this vernier calipers also to find out the inner diameter. If you want to find out the inner diameter of this beaker, see, this is how you are supposed to hold the beaker. Again, after holding the beaker like this, you will be taking reading of the main scale and vernier scale, and this will give you internal diameter of the beaker. And you can then, how to find out depth? See, there is one strip, you all can see this metallic strip, ye strip dikh rahi. So when you will put this strip over here and adjust the vernier calipers, you can find out depth of this beaker with the same observation table. Always you will just keep different heading. This is the observation table for diameter. Similarly, you will make another observation table for depth, and to find out the average value of diameter and depth using the formula pi r square h, you can find out volume of this given beaker. I hope it is clear to everyone. Thank you so much.